don't get many things right the first time. In fact, I am told that a lot. Now I know all the wrong turns and stumbles and falls brought me here. And where was I before the day saw your lovely face? Now I see it every day, and I know that I am the luckiest. What if I'd been born 50 years before you, in a house on a street where you live? Maybe I'd be outside as you passed on your bike. Would I know? And in a white sea of ice, I see one pair that I recognize. And I know that the luckiest. I love you more than I have ever found a way to say to you. Next door, there's an old man who lived to his 90, and one day passed away in his sleep. And his wife, she stayed for a couple of days and passed away. I'm sorry, I know that's a strange way to tell you that I know we belong.
Good morning, everybody. That's a Ben Folds song that I discovered. I think it's a really pretty song. But anyway, here's Reverend Sandy.
Thank you, John. Thank you so much. Well, good morning, everyone. Welcome here to Unity of Michiana Spiritual Center. It's always such a delight to see your faces and feel your presence here. And we also want to welcome those of you who are joining us via our live stream service across the miles, and know that we're all connected in heart, mind, and spirit. Here at Unity of Michiana, we are a heart-centered, multi-generational, and a diverse spiritual community. And we're dedicated to teaching and practicing a positive life approach in our spiritual journey. And our mission, our vision is a world united in loving acceptance, celebrating inclusivity, harmony, prosperity, and awakened consciousness. So as we gather here today and as we breathe into this moment, receptive to the gifts that are available through connecting with others of like mind, with open hearts, let us just breathe into this moment. And I will invite Catherine to light our Christ candle, which honors in each of us the light of the higher consciousness that Christ exemplified. And now if you'll join with me in an opening prayer. And just breathing into this moment and allowing the freedom, the flow of that which is infinite spirit. Whether we use the word God, whether we use the word of infinite creator or the source of all that is, we know that there is a greater layer within each of us at greater depth of being that connects to infinite spirit, that knows spirit is always available. And as we tap into, as we awaken to, as we remember the source of our being, as we breathe into the presence here and now, receptive to the gifts, grateful to share, open to the healing and the upliftment, we say thank you for the flow of beloved presence in and through all things for greatest good. And so it is. Amen. And now we'll have our youth come forward and Catherine will bless them for us.
I ask that you rub your hands together. We see you surrounded in the light of God.
We see you surrounded in the light of God.
And we hold you close in our hearts.
We hold you close in our hearts. Go and have a great time, everyone. So, John, I'll turn it over to you for our first opening song. Thank you.
This is a hymn from our hymn book that I don't think we've ever done before. So I'll play the first refrain. Yeah.
I have most full and free peace from simply trusting thee. Joy serene I hold all day when I follow Christ away. Love divine including to the small can be mine in that degree when I let it shine through me.
Everyone sing.
Safe from fears I am at home, from greatest to the small.
Sorry about that. Start that verse over. Safe from fears, I'm home. Though the Christ within my soul, rest I have in everything. When to thee I closely cling, satisfaction full complete fills me with its fragrance sweet. A body and a mind in the living Christ I find. I'm free, I am unlimited, I have no change abiding me. I am free, I am unlimited right now, I am free, I am unlimited, there are no chains that bind me. I am free, I am unlimited right now, you are free, you are unlimited, there are no chains that bind you. You are free, you are unlimited right now, you are free, you are unlimited, there are no chains that bind you, you are free, you are unlimited right now, we are free, we are unlimited, there are no chains to bind us. You are free, we are unlimited right now, right now. We are free, we are unlimited, there are no chains to bind us. We are free, we are unlimited right now, right now.
Thank you, John. I love that first one that was out of the Unity Hymnals.
Yeah.
I don't remember that, so I love the words, and what a great one. We'll have to revisit that.
Yeah.
So thank you very much. And now I'll invite Catherine to come forward and read our daily word from Unity's daily publication that brings us an inspirational message, and I will follow that with a time of mindfulness, prayer, and meditation.
Comforted, Sunday, September 29th, 2024. I am comforted by the divine presence within me. I'm grateful for the people who have understood how to comfort me when I was feeling down. They listened when I needed to talk and blessed me with their kindness. Often, they didn't need to say a word or do anything more than be with me for a while. Their understanding presence was what I really needed. Even if I am without the comforting presence of another, I can find comfort in the divine presence within me. As I open my heart to God, I feel understood, loved, and accepted completely, just as I am. I need not feel self-conscious about needing comfort or how I express my feelings. I need only feel the unconditional love of God. As my trust in the divine presence grows, my sadness diminishes. Healing peace flows through my entire being as I am comforted. As a mother comforts her child, so I will comfort you. You shall be comforted in Jerusalem. Isaiah 66:13.
Catherine, thank you so much. And such wonderful words that begin to breathe in and through us as she read for us our daily word. And so I invite you now to just let that presence and that energy of peace and comfort move through you as you gently close your eyes and as you breathe into this moment. letting each breath fill your lungs and then move through your body as it oxygenates your blood and moves through your circulatory system. As you recognize this flow of life that is inherent in our design. Let us breathe. Let us relax and let go. Let us simply be in this moment open and receptive to the infinite spirit that we would call God, Creator, the flow of life, infinite presence. For as we choicefully breathe, as we recognize and connect to that presence that is inherent within us, we recognize the beauty of this gracious power, not from our ego or our outer human experience, but the beautiful power of light and of love that infuses us, that we recognize as the design of who we are in various ways and in the unique expressions that we each share in the world. We are yet all designed and created of the same original source. So we breathe into that source and that awareness, and we allow ourselves to shift gently from the busyness of our outer world in order to just be one in the light, in the essence of love, immersed, upheld, healed, blessed, and comforted. For as we breathe into infinite spirit, we recognize the vast presence that flows in and through us, before us, all around us. And it shifts us from any sense of our limited outer human surroundings into a oneness of being with all that is. And so we rest in that oneness. We rest in the comfort of that peaceful presence that is who we are and yet is also all around us as well. And as we unite together in this consciousness of the vastness of our spirit, of our being, of our unique identity and expression, we begin to feel any walls that have been blocking us just begin to crumble and dissolve. For as we rest and reside in infinite source and being, all manner of opportunity opens before us that we may not have perceived before. and whether we recognize it consciously or unconsciously, we feel the activity of that spirit moving through us right here and right now in ways where our cells are enlivened, where our bodies respond with a sense of enthusiasm and zeal, where our spirit is engaged in shining forth, in living forth, in connecting with others. Until we rest quietly now for a moment in our own private communion, connection, oneness with Spirit, with God, with light, with love. And we feel the healing that occurs. We feel the blessing. We feel the inspiration in this time of silence. And in this silence where we feel connected to Source, to Infinite Presence, having been infilled with these blessings, we now shine our light forth to surround all the prayers that have been placed in our prayer box in that light, in that healing love. And we take this moment to speak aloud the names, places, situations that we would especially bless, knowing that there is power in the spoken word. Mary, Dale, Wanda, Warren, Joyce, Vicky, Evan, Donalyn, Joey, Kelsey, Noah, the whole family, Riley. Bob and Karen. John, Linda. Linda, Mike. Jax, Unity of Michiana, Unity Worldwide Ministries, World Headquarters, Tamara, Tim, Tamara, Sue Ann, Jolene, Richard, Frank, Kathy, Charlie and family, Shireen, Karen, Colleen and family, and so as we send these blessings forth, we know that the consciousness of prayer carries infinite presence and power. And we are grateful for the activity of Spirit manifesting in and through all for greater good. And so together we pray now and we say, Amen.
Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true, with thanksgiving I'll be a living sanctuary for you. Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true, with thanksgiving I'll be a living sanctuary for you. This is another Daniel Namad song that I really, really like a lot. Hope you enjoy it. I have made a decision about my life. It may be a strange surprise to some. I have always thought I wanted what so many others want, but it's a different conclusion that I've come. I see water rushing through an ancient riverbed. I see snowfall floating high up on a hill. I see an eagle soaring to a red horizon. And I know that's how I am meant to be. Oh, I need to be free, and I will go where the wind will carry me, to be free, oh, to be free. He won't see me playing any kind of lottery. You won't catch me wishing on a falling star. You will find me wherever I am called to be. Whatever kindness and beauty are. For I think of all mankind as my family. This entire planet is my home. So let others build their borders and their boundary. I will fly above them all. I will go where the wind will carry me to be free, oh, to be free. I will, when I hear child singing, when I see the dolphin swimming, when I watch a dancer floating like the wind, it's a calling, it's a vision, it's a voice that I must listen. So today, every day, I'm stepping in. Why me? To be free. And I will go where the wind will carry me to be free, oh, to be free.
Beautiful, beautiful. Daniel Nemod's song and a beautiful rendition of that. Thank you so
much. Oh, thank you.
So much, John. Yeah. Oh, gosh, friends. Well, this is the second half of a two-part series talk I started last week. The title is Honoring Integrity, Upholding Freedom, and Choosing Wisely. So I just want to recap a little bit. I talked a great deal last week about honoring integrity and upholding human rights and freedom. And in this day and age, with all that is happening in our world, in our spiritual evolvement, in our political arena in this nation, there are choices to be made that are very important to our integrity and to upholding our freedoms. And friends, this is not a time where we can sweep things under the carpet and say, oh, well, somebody else will take care of it, or no, it doesn't really matter that much. This is a time to be aware of how important integrity is in all areas of our lives, and to recognize that what we experience and what we see in the outer world, what do? We try and fix it out there. Well, guess where it starts? Who was here last week? Where does it start? Yeah, everybody's pointing within, whether you're here last week or not. Chrissy knows. John knows. Or, yeah, it's like, yes, friends. When we expect to live and to be surrounded by integrity, it's about us walking in that and noticing and being aware of the places, not to blame ourselves or not to beat ourselves up, but just to wake up, friends, and to notice the little slips and the little things that happen where we recognize and realize, okay, maybe I'm just not quite in integrity with that. Oh, I'm judging something. I'm not allowing someone else their freedom to be who they are because, gosh, they look different than I do. They act different than I do. Those little aspects in our lives that can oftentimes go unnoticed are the foundation of who and what we are and what we put out in our world. And guess what? It's what we put out in our world that we reap. And it's important to take action on that. In scripture from Hebrews 13, verse 16 and verse 18, it says, do not neglect to do good and to share what you have. We know that. We sometimes forget, you know, hoard things or whatever, but it's like remembering. It's up to us. It's not waiting for someone else. It's for us in our own way. And it may not be the way everybody else does, but to honor it in our own way. And in verse 18, it goes on to say, we are sure that we have a good conscience, desiring to act honorably in all things. Let's remember that. And to do as we are able in any given moment. And there is a tendency from the human egoic place where we blame ourselves or think that we can never live up to a standard. Well, that is something that we have imagined to be, friends. We are the standard as we stand in the light of our inherent connection to infinite spirit. And in Psalms 106:3, it says, blessed are they who maintain justice, who constantly do what is right. And friends, over the past many years, we have been faced not only as a nation, but also around our world with so many injustices and with a lack of human rights and equities. And it is more important now than ever to continue to stand for that. From amnesty.org, what we do, Universal Declaration of Human Rights. Human rights are universal, indivisible, and interdependent. So I took it from this website. All human rights are equally important, and all governments must treat human rights in a fair and equal manner, on the same footing and with the same emphasis. All states have a duty, regardless of their political, economic, and cultural systems, to promote and protect all human rights for everyone without discrimination. So no matter what distinctions people have, there is one basic principle that underlies all the rights that are outlined in the Universal Declaration of Human Rights that was adopted by the UN General Assembly in December, does anyone know? 1948, friends. This isn't a new concept. And yet it's taken a long time for us to live into and to live past entrenched belief systems of racial inequities, of discriminations. Goes on to say there can be no distinction of any kind, including race, color, sex, sexual orientation, or gender identity, language, religion, political, or any other opinion, national or social origin, of fortune, of birth, or any other situation. Universal means everyone, everywhere. 1948, and we have continued as spiritual humanity to live into breaking down major walls of separation of belief systems of old ego-based repressions and oppressions. And now more than ever, in a crucial time in what we are facing not only in our world, but as a nation, let us consider what do I stand for? In the workplace, when somebody, you know, there's gossip about someone, what do I stand for as I hear that? In my family, in my home, amongst different ideologies and belief systems, what throws me off track? What do I listen to? What do I put my attention to out in the world? Where do you hear things, or where do you make decisions from? Reliable sources like social media. Oh boy, yeah. Like, the gossip that we heard over here, like anybody else? So advertising, oh my gosh, advertising. Now, friends, it is important for us to have discourse and have conversation. And so social media, our advertisements, our conversations with family are important for us to listen, to hear. And yet it's important to recognize, where do we lose ourselves in those discussions, in our social media responses, in the advertisements that we see, in someone else's political stance? Well, they know more than I do, so they must be right. How often do we catch ourselves and say, to what source do I go to uphold my own personal integrity, to uphold what I believe in freedoms for all of humanity? And I would say, friends, fact checking is really important as much as we can. But what's the ultimate source, friends? Say again? Who said, huh? Our own values, and where does that come from? That presence of infinite spirit, of God, of source, that's present in us, not from our egoic mind. It doesn't go from here down within. It comes from within and up and out. And thanks, Chrissy. Yeah. It's so important to remember, friends, we are powerful. And we forget, and we go about our lives, and oh gosh, there's a plethora of stuff to distract us. And yet, where do we say, I stand for what is true and good and right? I stand for honesty. I stand for integrity. I uphold individuals, though I may not agree with their belief, though I may not, that would not be my choice, but I uphold that person's right to make that choice for themselves, friends. From Galatians in Scripture, Galatians chapter 6, verse 9, it says, so let us not grow weary in doing what is right, for we will reap if we do not give up. Let's not grow weary. And it sure is easy to sweep everything under the rug and go, it doesn't matter. But these things do matter at a time when our nation is in conflict and in uncertainty, and when we are on the brink, friends, of really important choices, not just in who we vote for in November. It's a very important choose wisely, but also every moment in our own lives, in how we show up and how we interact with others, in how we are present and what matters to us and who do we hang out with. In 1 Corinthians 14:13, it says, for God is not a God of confusion, but of peace. So while we see what seems like uncertainty and we see confusion out in the world, when we turn within, when we center, when we breathe into the heart of who we are, when we trust in that, when we listen to the still small voice, then we recognize the Godness of all being is not something of confusion. It is a wisdom of peacefulness. Many of you are familiar with Rumi, who is a Sufi mystic. He's a 13th century poet, an Islamic scholar, a theologian. He says, I have been a seeker all my life, but I stopped asking the books and the stars, in other words, things outside of myself, and I started listening to the teachings of my soul, friends. Now more than ever in this time, this crux time of stepping forward into something new. It is important for us to listen to our souls, to the truth of the presence of that voice of God within us. And all of us are aware of Nelson Mandela, the former South African president and anti-apartheid activist. He says, "May your choices reflect your hopes, not your fears, friends." So in these times of uncertainty, where do we stand in making wise choices, in recognizing our spiritual potential, in trusting that there is a greater energy and a greater activity that's at work in our world and in all the kind of chaos that seems to be going on out there? This is a crux time, friends, for each of us, you and I, to stand in our own integrity. Whatever your choices are, I'm not here to condone any political decision or choice one way or another. I am inviting each and every one of us to take self-responsibility, to be informed, to be aware when what someone else says affects us and maybe takes us off the path or down a rabbit hole. And believe me, our advertising, our social media is gifted at doing that, isn't it? How many of you have swung back and forth with everything going on out there and you just kind of go, ah, is that just me? No. We are all in this time of what's true, what's right, what is honorable. Letting God's wisdom guide us. We walk with integrity and we choose wisely, friends. Letting God's wisdom guide us. We walk with integrity and we choose then wisely because we're not at the effect of someone else's opinion or what they're saying, but we recognize the importance of not going back to old ego-based prejudices, belief systems, and ideas that as spiritual humanity, we have worked so hard even before 1948, but from then and on and continue to do. Let us not go back to old paradigms of beliefs and systems, friends. Let us choose to walk forward, to affirm in light the opportunities for all to uphold freedom. And again, whether it would be our choice or whether we are in alignment with that, but to uphold the freedom of each individual to have the right to make choices for themselves and not have someone else dictate what that is. It is more important now than ever that we stand up strong. And it doesn't mean to put anything else down. It simply means to look forward. To be that which we would want to be in our world, which we would want to see. Because as we begin to resonate with that, and not just in our political arena, but in world affairs, in our own lives, in our families, in the workplace, wherever we find ourselves, this is a time, as spiritual humanity, it is a shifting point where we are being called to come up higher, where we are being called to recognize the truthful integrity in which we are designed and to live into that. In the actions that we take, in the things that we do, and how we show up. From Proverbs 13:20, it says, "Whoever walks with the wise becomes wise, but the companion of fools suffers harm." Now, when we think about this, who do we want to surround ourselves with? We want to surround ourselves and be around people who are naysayers and doom and gloom and sort of pull us down? Or do we want to walk with those who recognize the light and the activity of infinite spirit? Like as we gather here today, to be uplifted, to be connected. Though it's not always easy, it's wonderful to know we have the strength of each other. And making choices for the goodness of all humanity as we go forward, we can do that more easily when we feel that support of each other. Walk with the wise to become wise. And from James 1, verse 5, it says, if any of you lacks wisdom, let him ask God, who gives generously to all without reproach, and it will be given him. You know, when we're being bombarded out there, friends, family, social media, advertisements on TV, talking, you know, wherever we are out and about, you know, sometimes we lose ourselves. So just remember to breathe for a minute, to shut out all the outer babble, and to just listen to self, to be one with infinite presence, and to then be guided to seek answers through truthful resources, to be well informed, and also to make one's own choiceful decisions, whether they match someone else's or not. But most importantly, to continue to go back and check on the integrity personally for yourself of those choices and those actions. I love this quote from Eleanor Roosevelt. She says, where, after all, do universal human rights begin? She says, they begin in small places close to home. What does that mean? Small places. It means you and I. Close to home. So close and so small that they cannot be seen on any maps of the world. Unless these rights have meaning there, they have little meaning anywhere. Without concerned citizen action to uphold them close to home, we shall look in vain for progress in the larger world. It's up to us, friends. It's up to us to make our choices. And General Ban Ki-moon, who was the former UN secretary, he was a diplomat. He says, human rights are for all of us, all the time. Whoever we are and wherever we are from, no matter our class, our opinions, our sexual orientation, human rights are for all of us. We sometimes forget in our busy lives and aren't focused, and yet that's when little things can slip under the radar. And we don't see where freedoms are being taken away, where oppression is returning, where the dignity of each human being is being questioned, where old oppressive belief systems are seeking control versus us living with freedom, with affirmation, into the light of becoming, of recognizing that every individual has that right for life, liberty, pursuit of happiness, for goodness, for prosperity, for a place to live without fear, for a way to be supported and upheld, friends. This is what is on the horizon for each and every one of us as spiritual beings, right here and right now. In a quote from Oprah Winfrey, I think we all know Oprah Winfrey, talk show host, of course, and an author and a producer. She says, the greatest discovery of all time is that a person can change his future by merely changing his attitude. Well, yeah, in Unity, we have taught that for a long time. We recognize that when we shift where our mind is focused, when we align with truth, it shifts from that changing attitude into a oneness of spirit in expression. So let us remember, this is a time to stand in that discovery that as we change our attitudes, we indeed change our world. And Elie Wiesel, who is a Jewish, was at one time a Jewish prisoner of Auschwitz. He is a Romanian writer, a professor, an activist. He was a Nobel laureate winner. He says, there may be times when we are powerless to prevent injustice, but there must never be a time when we fail to protest, friends. So this goes beyond what we see in our outer world. This goes to the heart of our very spiritual being, to our choicefulness, choosing wisely, to stand in our own integrity, to walk in that light, to trust in the presence of God, the wisdom of God, to support us in right action, in doing what is ours to do, not what someone else's, but what's ours to do, in being all that we can be right here and right now. And so in closing, I will share this quote from one from Socrates and one from Maya Angelou. Boy, are those two wisdom speakers. So, of course, we know Socrates was an ancient Greek philosopher. He says, the secret of change is to focus all of your energy not on fighting the old, but on building the new, friends. That's what we're about right here and right now, is building that new forward, facing forward, not grasping at what was or going back to the old paradigms, but absolutely putting our energy onto building that which is the new, which we are becoming. And Maya Angelou, of course, a poet, civil rights activist, she says, nothing can dim the light that shines within. Friends, we are all that light. It is up to us as we go forward and make choices wisely in our upcoming elections, in our everyday lives, in where we show up, in how we are. Let us affirm that light. Let us walk in love and integrity. Let us be that which moves us forward into a brand new tomorrow. So thank you, everyone, for being a part of this two-part series on honoring integrity, upholding our freedoms, our human rights, and choosing wisely. And so now I will quickly run through some of our happenings and events. So today is the Crop Hunger Walk, which Unity of Michiana has participated in for several years. Susan has been our leader and our coordinator for that. It will start at 2 p.m. today. Everybody will be meeting at the Zion Community Church, who is walking. We have already exceeded the donations we have received for the team that is walking. We exceeded our goal, so we're excited, and yet we would love to raise that even higher. So Susan sends out our e-news, and she sent that out on Friday. If you go Unity of Michiana, look at your past emails and see the e-news, and you scroll down to Crop Walk, there's a little line, a little link on there, man. Oh, thank you. Okay. And there's a little line on there, and you just click on that, and you can go in and give lots of money to this wonderful, wonderful cause. But participate in whatever way you choose to. Or if you'd like to walk with a group of us that are walking, please plan to be at Zion Church in downtown South Bend starting at 2 o'clock. And we're going to walk and just honor and acknowledge this wonderful project. Next, I'd like to let everybody know we've had a bit of a recess and a break in the Zoom group, the group that meets on Wednesday by this wonderful technology called Zoom. We come together on Wednesday. We concluded the book that we were studying, but we are resuming this next Wednesday, and we'll be moving through on a new book that is called Holy Moments. It's by Matthew Kelly. It's a beautiful, uplifting, easy to read opportunity to begin recognizing the holy moments that are all around us and affirming them in our lives. And so we usually have about a 20-minute, half an hour discussion, and then we follow that with a time of meditation and some music. So plan to join us. Susan sends out the link for that Zoom group on Wednesday. And if you are not on that email, you'd like to get it, be sure you let her know, so that you can just click on that link and come in and we all talk and we all share. It's a wonderful time. Goes from 6 to about 7:15-ish on Wednesday evenings. Please plan to join us. And our Moms Gathering Row, did you want to, Kelsey, would you like to say anything about it, or you want me to do the announcement? Okay. Okay, so... So Colleen has come together with Kelsey and Misty, and they have created this wonderful group called Moms Gather and Grow. It was meeting once a month on Monday evenings, and they have decided that a Sunday afternoon works better. So the next meeting will be Sunday, October 6th from 12:15 to 1:30. And you're invite moms or friends or people that you know that have kids and want that group to support. And there's going to be kind of a craft that everyone participates in, as well as that discussion. And there are Patty and Catherine take care of and work with the kids, the youth, so the moms can have their space. So let people know, plan to be here. If you're a mom or if you are serving as a mom, regardless of gender, be sure to plan to join on Sunday, October 6th, right after the service here at 12:15. And then I'm excited to announce that we are coming up on, can you believe it, our 5th anniversary here in this new location. So it is such an honor to bless and to appreciate all the prayer power, all the manpower, everything that went into moving to this new location and into then growing and manifesting through COVID, which happened right after we moved, and yet still that light that shines so brightly here. So on Sunday, October 13th, we will be celebrating two celebrations in one. That will be our anniversary, and we'll be doing some special blessings during the service. And then following that, we will go out. We had kind of what we call a soft opening. It was a gentle opening of our classroom pod. But this will be our grand opening of what we've always called our classroom pod, which is actually the trailer that is a meeting place for our youth. And so we're also calling it the Youth and Community Spiritual Activity Center. So we're going to have the grand opening of that. And we'll have free hot dogs, soda, chips for all who are in attendance. We'll have fun and games for the kids and activities. And we would ask that you, there's flyers out on the tables in fellowship. Susan, they're posted on our website. You can share it onto your social media and invite people to come and see what we are all about. Everyone says we're one of the best kept secrets there is out there. Well, this is the time to let our light shine, to announce it, to be it, and to have people come and join us. So please get the word out, and we'll have a little special blessing. The youth are going to speak. The board will speak. I will speak shortly, very shortly. But have a fun time and see what Unity of Michiana is all about. And in light of that, because we felt to call that the classroom pod, which kind of people didn't really know for sure what that was, we thought it would be fun to have a naming contest to name it something fun. So there is a box in the back where you can write out, put your name on it so we can contact you. But if you come up with a name, do that. Those of you who are watching online, feel free to either email Susan or you can drop something right now into the conversation box. And be a part of this wonderful contest. Once everyone has submitted their applications or their suggestions, the final date for that is Tuesday, October 15th, and the board will then review all the entries and we'll choose a winner. So I think, Chrissy, you came up with what, the Kiddos something? Kiddos Kingdom. I came up with the Hobbit Hut. You know, that's not really my entry, but it was so cute. It just reminds me of that. But, you know, it's like, let's have fun with this. Let's, you know, spirit lights it. You know, just let your creative mind go and come up with a special name so that we can name this wondrous place that we have to support our youth and also to support our community. If people have classes they want to teach in yoga or in drumming or in all these things, we have a place for people to do that. So please do plan to join us for both celebrations on Sunday, October 13th. Invite friends, invite family, invite everyone that you know. Take the flyers out. Leave them, ask, you know, when you go into whether you have a yoga class or a meditation group or you go to a drumming circle or you go to the doctor's office or you go to the market, ask them if you can post the flyer and let's invite all of this community to know who we are, and at a time when we can give thanks for the amazing hard work over the past 5 years that has gone into creating this wonderful meeting activity center. So that concludes our announcements for today, and so I'll invite you now into breathing the consciousness of the source of infinite prosperity and abundance. And recognizing that the financial gifts that we give are simply a representation of the energy of infinite source. And they are what keep our doors open, what keep us moving forward. Because all of you are the sole support and the sole income for Unity of, well, mostly the sole income for Unity of Michiana. So we are grateful for that. And so you can go either to unitymichiana.org, you can go to our Unity Michiana phone app, you can take a picture of the QR code in the back or on the screen, or, you know, for those of you at home, please join us in this affirmation of our abundance, our growth, our moving forward. And our affirmation for today is, God is my support and my abundant supply. I give and receive in freedom and joy. And so as we stand in integrity, that integrity is the awareness of the presence of God that flows through us and everywhere all around us. We are that activity of spirit in expression. We are the abundance manifesting forth. We give gratefully and we say thank you. And so it is. Amen. And now we'll all rise and we'll join in singing our peace song and our prayer for protection. And just a little note that we're going to change slightly, just slightly, the order of service. We'll do that on our anniversary Sunday. Just a few little changes, which is always so fun. Isn't change great? Yeah. So join us now in our Let There Be Peace on Earth.
Let there be peace on earth. Let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth. That was meant to be with God as our creator, family all are we. Let us walk with each other in perfect harmony. with every step I take, let this be my solemn vow. To take each moment and live each moment in peace and calmly. Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me.
The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us, the power of God protects us, and the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well. And so it is, and so we let it be. Have a wonderful week. Choose wisely.